know, he's lucky too bad, you know.
Mashing up.
He's mashing up everybody. The whole team lost him, but that ain't nothing. Lara hitting them with wickets. He's breaking record.
Watch out.
I hope so, you know. I hope so. He's seen many papers today with that set of woman. I've been yachting. That set a woman on the boat. I said, look at Lara, the sound boy. Like, if they record a lonely plan to break, because he was red, playing himself, you know.
I said, you go ahead, Mr. Lara. I'm proud to do that.
Because I don't know, I want the children and I want the little boys and the little girls to see the kind of accomplishment that these people go, you know, they're hitting and they're beating and kicking ball.
Yeah. But when you work hard, you will achieve.
Yeah. That's all it is, you know. It ain't no big science, you know. It ain't no big maths. You work hard, you will get plenty rewards and awards. That is what it has happened to me. And Brian Lara, the Trinidad football team, all of them breaking records are getting through.
The people on the map.
I'm glad, you know, boy. I feel real proud.
I wonder what they go give Brian Lara for all this that he do.
Me, you know them. I hope them one make no play, no nothing after him. Let's give him a play. Remember when Penny come as young, they win the arm thing? The beautiful competition, and they share playing, you know. She ain't playing after. Hey, talking about playing, boy, I went up passing. We take a little drive on the weekend, Sunday. After that, hear the news about Devon. He buried today, you know, the little boy telling the Bobo.
Lord,
I say a prayer for him. I hope the Lord look at him. But I passed by the airport, Leroy. I want you to hear me, talking about playing.
I
see this big plane they have in front of Piako Airport. The thing looking tacky. If you see it, they dress up, man, Merry Christmas. Now, I don't know who I did was that they thought they could have put a plane in front of the airport. But, you know, and man, you want to see it, you know. The thing like it make out a styrotex, and they just throw in 2-3 pieces of little ribbon over it, and then like the plane too bad.
Not a real plane.
Like, I made a big plane out of styrotex, and they throw the ribbon and the ribbon flying. Hey, where, and they have a little net for the door. It look nice, eh? It looked nice, but I find it didn't suit for the airport, man. It kind of had a kind of tacky finish.
I don't know this country. It didn't look professionally done.
No, it didn't look professionally done. I don't know, understand. They could have put something nice and more Merry Christmas anyway. Mm-hmm. I was the same plane, I remember seeing this ugly big thing in front of the airport.
You know,
but I hope that they give Mr. Lara something woody. No plane. You ever want that plane? You want to be able to fly your plane? Then they be playing after the girl. But she can be going to play now.
I never hear about that plane again.
Never hear about that. Was in 76 when Janelle win it. Yeah, they call it the Penny Comis Young Boeing plane. Everybody play. So they shouldn't give the man a plane.
Yeah, because they think my woman give money
Nah, he have money. And he have a house. They gave him a house already, you know, up in Amley, the Chancellor of the. I think they have a big house up there with their straight party.
He have no money
because your straight big party for about $300-$400. It's not going there, you know. It's not paid to go into that party. People like me and you, so we can't get in that party, you know. $500-$600 you have to pay all inclusive to the scholarly party.
So
he has get money from that. So he has no money.
He don't need no money.
He don't need no plane, he don't need no house.
No lie.
They had to give him something, you know, something good that the people will remember him. The children will remember him. They will say, Brian Lara, that is the man who break all the records that they have in cricket.
Because he's
going to break more, you know. Yes, stop, you know.
No, boy, young,
he could still break more records. That is what I want them to give him, something that when children and them, they could identify. Like a statue.
A statue on the promenade itself.
A statue on the promenade. They don't have a statue on the promenade already.
But you have a statue of Brian Lara. On the promenade now.
Brian Lara statue on the Brian Lara promenade.
I see what you're talking about.
Brian Lara, that is a statue. A statue. So children will be able to look up to
when
him.
When they pass.
A high statue. So big man and woman could look up to him too. That is nice. a statue is a good idea, you true. A nice statue. I know they will make it out a bronze or gold or something.
Something
shiny. Yeah, when the sun hits it, so you batter on a guy glare. That is what they want. And
just get another idea, Miss Rosie.
What's that?
Maybe we could get a statue for Mr. Fabian.
Oh, you mean?
We didn't get anything for your birthday, remember?
Well, nobody wants to talk about it.
So we can make a big, tall statue. So people in the guy will look up to Mr. Fabian too.
I think he does look up to him already, you know. So you feel if we make a statue, you
go to make a statue.
Well, if it's one, he's deserving of a statue, you know.
Yeah, we could get all kind of items. Like Mr. Fabian, we can make a life-size statue. And we can get a picture of his face and put it to the top.
Well, you say, get all the kind of things and make up a statue. What it is you really say?
Well, things Mr. Fabian like.
So, take a set of things Mr. Fabian like and stick it together?
Yeah, I make a tall statue and you top it off with a picture of his face on it.
Well, you just get these ideas, Leroy.
Creative to take it, Miss Rosie, and we save it, and it's a good idea. You
so think, what kind of thing you think?
Unique.
What kind of things you think that we should get to put on this statue? Because I don't understand things that Mr. Fabian like.
Yeah, you do.
Like cocoa tea then, and thing?
Yeah.
You like cocoa tea, you know?
Yeah, so we can use that for the legs or something.
Yeah, you know, you like salad and thing, you like food or you like your belly, you know?
Yes.
Yeah, so it's looking maga day, but you like your belly too bad, you know?
Yes, yeah, so that could be the waste.
What's that, the food thing?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So you're getting some cocoa tea thing and some food thing in the middle for the waste.
Right.
And what other kind of things you have?
I wanted to be an astronaut and explore space. Now I want to be a lawyer or an actress. My dad tells me that I'm stupid and slow. He says that I'll end up on the streets like those other dumb people. He keeps saying that I'm just like my good friend.
So, homemade and thing, you know, and that nice. You know, these people just want to go and be buying thing in the store, and you know, that really would.
From the heart. So you go appreciate
it. Stuff that you make with your hands.
Yeah.
That is nice. So Mr. Fabian, go appreciate that.
Yeah, so we can gather stuff from the guy or anything.
Yes. I like the cocoa tea idea, and getting some food for the bed.
Yeah, and he like computers. So we could get like the monitor and put it as his head. And stick the picture
on the monitor and
face.
Right, that is good. And he like vegetable and he don't eat meat and things, you know.
No.
So we can get fruit and things.
Some like vegetable cans.
You like vegetable cans and I like that. That's a good idea.
And
Mr. Fabian will appreciate that.
So don't you alcohol or anything. So we can put sweet drink bottles.
Sweet bottles.
Yeah.
Nice idea.
And pictures of each children on it.
Right, nice, yes.
That's something
I'm excited. You know, I'm not gonna start you making an offer. I failed that when I was going to school. I wasn't gonna start you making. I think this is one thing I might have to do on your own.
But
tell Mr. Fabian, I help you, you know. I'll get the things and things for you.
But at least help me gather up this stuff.
These things, so that you make a tall.
Yeah, tall. So that everybody could look
in the Gael.
Yeah.
So maybe it's a good place to think you could put it.
Right by the entrance, by the couch.
I think by the exit might be a better place, you know.
Right.
Or the back room, whatever room in the back would be dark.
But then nobody will see it, and Mr. Fabian will have to go quite in the back all the time to see his statue.
But that is okay, you know, it will be in a nice personal place and people won't be able to touch it up and take. You know when that statue, people want to be interfering with it, choking it. So because in the back room in the dark.
They might want to take the bowl and take the purple food in, and that wouldn't be
beautiful. That wouldn't be nice. So I suggest to you, I know the front where everybody comes in is a good place, but the better place is to see the back room, it have been back there, the back room in it. Walking on the corridor straight about the third room on the right,
Real
dark.
even have a light in the mess room, see?
But it's air condition. It will keep the vegetables and them safe and long.
But it have no light. How anybody will see it?
Well, they know how to see it. You know, they could feel the statue. Don't worry, Mr. Fabian, but still appreciate it.
So what about putting something to barricade it?
But, you need to get something.
And make like a little sign and thing for it.
I don't think you would need all of that, you know, because the place could be a little dark now. So it's enough if they go in and they could just feel it. And they feel around it and they will know that is a work of art. And they will recognize it.
I'm not too sure about that, because then they might throw it down.
Well, no, you see, we'll have a sign outside the door to go fragile inside.
So be careful.
Be careful and entering. Right, so they will go in very slowly and carefully and try to feel the way around. And then they go feel the statue and they go realize the greatness.
Yes,
and then they go close the door and they go leave it alone.
Yeah.
All right, so you don't have to worry. Don't worry about the statue, right, Mr. Fabian? I will really appreciate it.
Yeah.
I think it's better in the back.
In the back.
Yeah, in the back where I'm
gonna really like it with everybody when they
I know you won't like it in front of everybody, but don't worry.
Come in the morning and they
I know,
see it.
I know, and it's okay, but
they can like greet the star
hello morning, but you know what they could always go in the back room and tell you about the third room and the right.
They
could just people and say, "Hey, Mr. Fabian," and close the back and they will feel like they see it. You see?
Okay.
They will know that that room is the statue room.
Okay.
Because they go put up a sign all over the Gael.
Okay,
anybody
right.
Want to worship the statue of Mr. Fabian, go down to the third room in the back of the dark room.
Arrows
is a nice idea too.
Yeah.
Right? So you don't worry about the statue. You don't worry about that. All right?
Okay. It's just a nice idea. Worry about the Gael and all the stuff as soon as possible, because he put it on. Going
that is okay. That is all right. You'll appreciate it.
I will leave red scotch tape for that masterpiece, boy.
Yeah, you need a lot of scotch tape.
Yeah.
I will help you donate that. I will donate that to you. I will donate about two wrong things that need the scotch tape.
Right.
All right. But just remember, whatever you do, keep it in the back.
Keep
it. We don't want the statue in the front when people come into frighten. To make people aware of it now. We want people to see it in the back.
Well, it might be kind of heavy, so I would build it in the back one time.
That is a good idea. Build it in the back one time.
Yeah.
Alright, that's a nice idea. Oh, Lord, but I hope this Baron Lara get through, you know, boy.
Yeah.
I hope he get through with something. I hope the government and then decide to do something with him. But what you going to do for a man who have everything?
This statue could be realized in the mistress. The promenade in the center.
Statue, Matthew, whatever. Me, I know that. Me if I own some great post, me I want a statue. People us what kind of bullets kind of mess on the statue when rain fall, what kind of mosses get on the statue. Next thing you can recognize him is Brian, I look like it a yampy because something stick in the eye. And all kind of, me I appreciate the statue giving thing, you know. And then people doesn't build statue to your likeness properly, you know.
Perfect.
You remember when they built the first Sparrow statue? That was a mess. I hear people couldn't recognize it. They don't Sparrow look like Buddha.
Didn't know.
So you have to be careful with statue making. It's not a thing that anybody could do. It's a particular art form.
Yeah.
You have to give a real artist like you. I know you're the artist.
Yeah.
And when you finish with that one in the back day, it will blow away everybody.
Yeah,
that is why
it's
a good idea we have the light off.
Yeah.
So people ain't going to be blown away too much.
Yeah, and when they come in, they won't see it.
Right.
And still have to finish.
So your mother
going good. Talking about my mother and remember the situation with the money. I get extra job over the weekend.
You get a job over the weekend?
Yeah.
That just goes so your mother won't have to be harassing you about
yeah,
the tax and the breakfast and the lunch and thing.
Yeah, bartending.
Yep.
I could go in and do some bartending. Play Miss Rosie.
You're going to do bartending at a place?
Yeah, nice play called Real.
Real?
Yeah.
Who will win this play?
A short Rasta lady and some people that put it together.
What is the name of the organization?
I think Necessary.
Necessary? That's what you hear about it.
Yeah, I was passing by the theater.
Which theater? Central Bank?
No, the little... Character Theater.
Oh, they mean Little Character Theater?
Yeah, and they had a big poster up, and I was passing, and they were rehearsing, and they sung it real good, you know, Miss Rosie.
Right.
Yeah, they're looking real good. So I went in, and I asked the boss lady if she needed any help with this. The stage work
because you're a carpenter,
yeah,
right.
But then this is she said, no, we have enough help with that. So I liked the idea of going on. Button at this play, so I asked her if she needed a bartender, and
right.
She said yes. I said, I have a real bartender, and she was practicing. She gave me a little rundown about what the play was about. It's about real situations that going on that young people that go through and everything, Miss Rosie. It looked real nice.
Yes, yes, I mean,
she seemed like a real nice person too.
She offered you this job?
Yeah, she said, well, coming down now to the ending, it was confusing. So she said she'll leave me to organize the bar. So I go and I organize the bar.
So she got this too much for she to
it's
do?
It's too much work going on because she had a directed to play on everything.
Right, and you get to meet the bartender. So what?
I get the bartender.
So when the play opening?
Opening this Friday. Uh-huh. Friday, Saturday and Sunday.
Oh, so you have a training little walk there. That's a good thing, you know.
But
you gotta take your end where you go get it, you know, Leroy.
Yeah,
you can be scornful, you know.
Every little penny.
Every little penny come. That is one of the strike to tell Johnstone. And don't try to reach for the mountain and still have you have a little valley to deal with.
Yeah.
That is good. So what you gonna sell in this bar now, Leroy?
Well, I decided some.
That is theater thing, eh? That is nice, and people dress up and go to the
I know me Mr. Okay. I get time for everybody. So
that
I have
nice
little bush tea set out.
Bush
all
tea?
All different kinds of bush tea.
Yeah. You're selling bush tea in the people play?
Yeah, Mr. Bush tea, that tastes real good, you know. Real good.
So you have bush. I suppose that bush tea is already. People just have Lipton tea and cocoa tea and all kind of thing.
Yeah.
I suppose a little bush tea go with nobody.
Healthy, yeah.
Right.
And it will keep them up.
Right. And what again?
Porridge.
You selling porridge in the people play?
Porridge.
Porridge. You think this is a good idea?
Yeah, Mr. Healthy things.
Porridge and bush tea.
Yeah.
I can see it on the chart now. You have to write up a list, you know, a bar list.
Yeah, and of course, water.
Water. That is essential. That is good. That is good.
And
you have real water.
real water. And cinnamon and salt. Yeah. Cinnamon and salt.
Where you get that from?
I heard about it. I hear good for
Sene and salt, boy. Sene.
Yeah.
You can't be having Sene and salt in the people play and then.
No,
you crazy? You want people to be diarrhea while you're watching the play? You want people to be steady running to the toilet? You hear about Sene and salt and you just want to serve it? You know what that is? That is a flush you out, you know.
Oh, the flush.
Flush you out, you know, Sene and salt.
I thought it was something to keep you cool.
No, darling.
Feel real good when you finish taking.
Yeah, when you finish in the toilet, you just feel real good. So I wouldn't advise you to take Sene and salt to the people play and take. Why you sell things like other things, like little soft drinks and little apple jay and pear drops and little sorrel and thing is Christmas.
Yes, but I will have to buy all them things, Miss Rosie, and my budget kind of tight.
Well, you should ask the lady to give you a little help donation. Then when you sell the things, you will make a profit and give her back. You understand?
Oh,
you have to sell things that people will buy.
Right.
You can't go and sell porridge and sene and salt and bush tea in the people play.
No.
You crazy or what? You want the woman to get locked up? People think they buy one thing and they get the next thing. The next thing, people busy in the toilet.
And then they miss the whole
person. Then they miss the play. Then they go have a real bad time. And you don't want that. thinking about things that you could sell, proper things. So when people come, they're going to enjoy, they will drink the little sip of whatever it is, and they go and they watch the play and they leave for the intermission and they come and they buy from you. And you have to be a real attentive bartender, you know.
Okay, cool. So the drinks, change the drinks.
Yeah, you have to change them drinks. I ain't think them drinks because a little salt drink, little shandy. Me and no, that is women or alcohol, a little beer or whatever. Me and no,
okay,
these
okay.
The kind of things that are selling places, you know.
Okay.
So you ever went anywhere and they sell porridge?
No, not really.
That is for home in the morning when they go to mother house. You bring a little porridge to break the wind. But you know, we going to people place to drink porridge.
Okay.
All right, what you gonna sell to eat?
Oh, yeah, right, to eat. Right, I'm selling.
You're watching Gaia, the Caribbean.